She's standing. Amir Abdullah going to take it out of the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses up about 4 yards.
tries to get the football back.
Well, the decision there, fourth and goal, they go for it. But this ball intercepted in the end zone.
Hey, how about some applause for the stand by this defense? Just to force them into a fourth and goal situation was one thing. But then to get the interception, keep them off the scoreboard, that's a job very well done.
First carry for Nick Chubb.
The entire game. I can feel it.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea. Slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
Now, this is complete downfield on the left side. And they get him down the mound before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That'll move the sticks for the Browns, a gain of 12. Back-to-back good plays, has him on the move on first down. A first carry out for Kareem Hill.
Downfield the first down.
Line of scrimmage with 31 now on first and 10. Mayfield hands it off to Chubb. Now this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football right now.
Absolutely, pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they did get the first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard.
Bro, let's run the ball, fool.
Mayfield looks to throw. He'll get this one underneath to help. They bring him down at the 18-yard line. A gain of 5. Good enough for the first down.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he was watching the game. He's like, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to count for their passing game? That's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back out of the backfield. In this case, he gets up a first down.
From the red zone now, Mayfield.
Hey, watch out, bro. I'm not picking you up, bro.
And Marcus Kittle has good. So an opening day field goal unit is just driving the friends in, and I think that they will take it.
There's no doubt about it. They will always take their own lead, and maybe that celebration comes later if they play well and they can make things easier. But right now, this is all about letting Eddie Precious do something good.
And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line.
Offensive coordinators talk about, and your conversions either to the touchdown
check down. It was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down. A nice safe throw and a good one. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 in the first. On play action. Cousins. Complete. Jefferson to target. And it's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. The Vikings going to signal for the first of the timeouts. As they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. First and goal, they have a chance to get right back in this football game.
Pressure comes and down. Here's Baker Mayfield. Denier Howard.
stop, get the football back, and they've done just that. And here's Gillen on now. The punt as he gets this one away. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And the Vikings will take over here first and 10.
Thank you. tried to throw at him and beating him into the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
Parkey with the extra point, and that'll make this a three-score game, and the lead moves to 17. So they'll get another shift in offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Now Abdullah will return. And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26. Here the Vikings now to start their next drive. And that last pick six may have been the backbreaker as they now face a three-score deficit in the fourth quarter. They need points quickly. This is going to fall to the ground incomplete. That very nearly their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second and 10. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you have to
Where'd you get that marker from? Y'all didn't draw. Why you play from drawing your face? Why you do that for me? But why didn't you let him do it? So now I'm gonna whoop both of y'all again. Give me that marker. It looks like they has been pouring on goddamn marker because his mouth is blue. Tori got marker all on his damn arm. You can get the
Get off of me, man. Yeah, watch out, bro.
Take it.
action now.
And this is his second, and that should do it. Put down Ronnie Harrison. That is going to be turned up to the 20.
Thank you.
And not much to speak of. Calling a one-yard gain up to the 26. He'll wind up getting a yard on the game's first play at second down. From the gun, Murray. That's out to the flat for Edmonds. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A gain of 10, first down Arizona.
I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so, and gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it and really gets them amped up as they go forward.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Comes to Murray and one. This one's caught by Isabella. And he's out of bounds, but able to get it past the 45. 12 more yards there and another first down.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so sympathetic for those DBs, aren't you? Throwing on first down is Murray. They're going back to the flag for Edmonds. And they get to him after a gain of six to the 46.
I'm not sure if this play was designed for him specifically, but they got the three rushes and got the ball to him. So second catch on the drive. He may not be a primary guy, but they definitely
have him back. Two catches, so if they can get him going the passing game, it should open up his running game too. From the gun on third down, Murray. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins. And he is going to have a Cardinals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward. First and 10, here's Murray. He'll swing that out to Edmonds. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. To throw again on second down, Murray. And he's going to get this inside the 30. The Cardinal passing game dialed in now. First down. Defensively, they need to figure something out. Happening by him, but he has four catches.
And if you have to figure out how to stop him defensively, that usually means you weaken your defense. That means that now the offense is doing the dictating, and they should have other things open up as well.
Murray now on first down. And the catch made by Hopkins. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Murray to air it out again. That's complete once again to Hopkins. That catch good for five. It's third down. Out of the gun, here's Murray. It's complete to Hopkins. And he's going to have a Cardinals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. No score after one on EA Sports. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Now Murray. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back in the 14. And it's never going to take a sack. You really don't want to take one down here in this part of the field, down here in the end zone.
Not at all, because you're already pretty much assured.
short of a field goal. But you take a big sack, it could push you out of range, and that's why defenses get a little more aggressive in this situation. They're almost conceding the 3 points. They want to push you back and try to take you out of that.
Firing quickly here, that's complete. They'll get Neil Harris, that sets him up better for third down. And so far, a very nice, methodical opening drive.
This has the feel of a scripted drive that they rehearsed perfectly all week long, and now they're executing it on game day.
Script looks good so far. So two of two on third down conversions, and Buster's going in the face of 4-3 right here. There's Murray. Chase Edmonds, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Cardinals take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Well, that time, Philip, took up an eternity. We finally have some action on the scoreboard.
Yeah, but plenty of action prior to, because that drive took up all the first quarter before it was spilled into the second, and finally, points were registered.
On the other sideline, they're chopping at the bit just to get the football.
Thank you.
Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll show you the one there. Jonathan Coachman is standing by the highlights and analysis of this first half. And again, down here at the 42. Solid on the first down to 7-2 in the second and 43. Now a good game. And he's going to get it into the 33-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. They're down on first down, Edmonds. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down on the handoff. It's Edmonds. And he stopped immediately there. Call it no gain there. They're looking at a 30-13.
The running lanes have definitely been there for the
I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given you much space. A loss results there. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Over the middle, that's Hadlin by Isabella. And he's good for the first down, coming out short as he's tackled at the 25.
But don't tell any defensive coordinator I played for, but that might be considered a win for both teams because defensively they stopped them short and forced the fourth down. But offensively, they picked up enough yards to get their kicker a better shot if that's what they wanted to do.
It's really hot.
The field goal unit's going to stay put on the sideline. And they're going on fourth down here. They're going for it. It's Murray. That is going to be the Cardinals unable to convert there on fourth down. And as a result, it'll be time for the ball on the turnover on downs. Tennessee offense about set, ready to go. And when they're trailing back, there's still enough time to try to string a few plays together and maybe get the field goal range. That's into the crowd and intercepted. Jalen Thompson picks it. An unfortunate sequence there, trying to get points before intermission, but now the interception, and their opponents have a chance to possibly take their lead.
Yeah, they had an opportunity there, and they weren't able to capitalize on it, and that's something that could come back and haunt them later. The big name defense has to keep them from scoring before the half ends.
After the turnover, here's Murray. Looking right side, that's caught by Moore.
Get away! Put that come up in the trade. Tell him to put that in the trade.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about
Thursday church.
As long as we're there after catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards,
hey! I'm here.
Back at the 5 yard line now, the second and goal. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the line. The Cardinals forced to run their third and final
touchdown.
As they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half.
Well, why the fuck is you lying?
They'd really like to get this shot for the game. We'll see if they can. This is the start of the game.
That's the best of it.
Because
defense is now a one-score game. Hey, Nate, this is what you need to slow the momentum change, because otherwise, after you run your team, you got to be careful right here.
17 yards on the catch and run. It's a first down.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open just a little underneath him, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Gather not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
First down, Murray. Forced out to his left. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run. Shotgun now for Murray. That'll be caught. It takes a bullet. And they'll end up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. That went nearly 30 yards, 29 officially. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Zone. Here's the Heisman Trophy winner, Murray. He'll get these two's running back, Edmonds. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. They'll contain him to just four, second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Picked off by Byron Murphy, and he's going to take this one back.